Welcome to the flagship studio here at the J.P. Morgan Health Conference 2024. Back in the chair with us again this year is Mike Nally, the CEO of Generate Biomedicines. Very big year in 2023 for Generate, including speeding forward with a clinical pipeline. Can you talk a bit about that, Mike?
Well, thanks, Christine. Thanks for having me. You know, 2023 was a great year for the team at Generate. You know, I think when you start working on these sort of transformational technologies, you're always asking yourselves, you know, how quickly can we translate it into human impact? And, you know, for us to see our first two clinical programs, move forward was a monumental achievement by everyone that has touched the technology since the inception of the company 5 years ago. You know, what we've really focused in on is, you know, where can this technology uniquely help humanity? And, you know, if you go back a couple of years ago, you know, at the time, one of the seminal challenges facing humanity was the emergence of Omicron. And we said, you know, could we use this technology to distinguish how we address the spike protein? Could we actually try and address...
Feels topical again this
year. Yeah, it's coming back. But, you know, could we address the conserved epitopes that aren't under the same evolutionary pressure as the receptor binding domain? And we were fortunate to find an antibody and, you know, design an antibody that targets the S2 domain of the spike protein. You know, this is held up...
This is, for non-scientists, the part that doesn't mutate.
That's exactly right. And so this is held up
against
all variants of concern.
Wow.
And so, you know, the intent is to actually use it in the prophylactic population.
I would think governments would be very interested in that. Have you talked to governments about that aspect?
There's some interest, but, you know, the reality is that the COVID has become so political.
It's true.
Both, in the U.S. and around the world, you know, we all are wishing, you know, this virus will go away. Unfortunately, it's likely to be with us for our lifetimes. And so protecting those at greatest need is still a huge area of unmet medical need. And we think this technology could do just that. Our second program was an anti-TSLP antibody. And this is just an exquisite molecule. When you think about what we're trying to do, we're pushing the boundaries of biophysical measurement. When we started out with this program, we were hoping that, you know, for asthmatics, we could find a regimen that would actually move dosing to every 6 months.
Oh, wow.
And what we saw with this molecule was that we could drive binding affinity to levels that almost evade our ability to detect with cutting edge instruments. So we're down to 106 femtomolar binders. That drives a fivefold improvement in potency over the currently marketed antibody targeting the same target. And we think 6 month dosing is now realistic. And so for us, you know, these are huge, huge opportunities to not only address major areas of unmet medical need, but also to highlight the capability of this platform, not just to get better or medicines to patients faster, but importantly, get better medicines to patients faster.
Got it. And there's a real theme this JPM, it's palpable, around partnerships
totally.
And deals. And just before the conference, you announced an expansion of your partnership with Amgen. It's one of many partnerships that you've announced over the last year. What will you and Amgen, what will Generate and Amgen be doing additionally or now?
So we were really fortunate 2 years ago to sign, you know, kind of a groundbreaking deal for us with Amgen. You know, the team at Amgen have just been extraordinary in terms of their willingness to, you know, enrich us with their scientific expertise, their protein engineering capabilities, their clinical development, manufacturing capabilities, you know, to really, you know, push us and our technology to new heights. You know, we had an initial collaboration that spanned five different targets.
Okay.
We've made substantial progress on all five of those targets.
Great.
And it's based on, you know, the product of that work and the strength of the collaboration that they said, you know, as they got to know the technology better, here was a new area of unmet medical need that this technology could potentially uniquely address. And so, you know, we're delighted to continue to expand the relationship with Amgen. As you know, partnerships are really hard in all walks of life. And we've had
so much experience in previous roles in this role and really figuring out what makes a partnership gel.
Well, you know, I don't pretend to have all the answers, but the reality is, you know, the foundation for a good partnership is always trust. And it's doing what you're going to say. You know, when you say you're going to do something, then you do it. And on both sides, I feel like with the Amgen partnership, we've had strong commitment, alignment of vision, and then a foundation of trust. And I think that trust has only grown over the past 2 years. And I think as we look forward, you know, it's partners like that where we have complementary capabilities, right? We know we need to lean on Amgen for their disease area biology expertise. We can add something unique on our machine learning capabilities, right? And it's through that synergy between their strengths, our strengths, that ultimately we can continue to push the scientific agenda and ultimately hopefully make a big difference in this world with the medicines we create.
You talked about what lies ahead, and I want to come back to that. But first, when you talk about vision and commitment and trust, it's a reminder to me that Generate from its earliest days you've had a laser focus on culture. And culture at Generate is something that is in the air. You talk about it, you breathe it. For someone who doesn't know the company, what should they know about the culture at Generate?
Well, it would be a shame if I took all credit for that by any means. You know, the founders of Generate, the team at Flagship, Molly Gibson, Gabor Gregorian, they established such a strong foundation from which I could build. The reality was, from day one, there was such a distinct respect for multidisciplinary capability. And oftentimes, you know, when you see these sort of computationally native companies, you have either the computational scientists in service of the biologists or the biologists in service of the computational scientists. At Generate, it's been remarkable how the company has been built with a deep level of respect on both sides. So the computational scientists that come and work at Generate want to experimentally validate all of their work. The experimentalists recognize the power of computation to aid the experimental process. And it's been a huge contributor to kind of, you know, the overarching culture. Now, obviously, we've borrowed from, you know, some of the cultural elements of Flagship. Like, we talk about audacious ambition, we talk about insatiable curiosity, we talk about, you know, scientific integrity. We also talk about being digitally native. We talk about being fiercely united. Those are the qualities. And I think as we've reflected as an organization, as these programs have entered the clinic, the value that we really felt was missing was around being patient first. And so as we've migrated basically from a technology company to a technology company applied to biology with programs in the clinic, you know, heightening that patient focus,
you've got that patient orientation,
has been a big, big deal in the past year.
I think, you know, as you marry the biologist and experimental scientists with computation, so many companies are going to be built trying to cross those barriers and merge those languages. It's one of many areas where Generate's a leader. Your Chroma paper this past year, it's fair to say that in the area of generative medicines, generative AI, a lot of people are looking to Generate. What will they see in 2024? What will you lead on in 2024?
Well, one of my favorite things that we sometimes encounter, Christine, is that, you know, people say, you know, are you named Generate because of generative AI? And obviously, you know, when the company was named 5 years ago, you know, generative AI was not part of the common lexicon.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, it was a lot of foresight by the founders to sit there and say, you know, this technology will help us understand biology in really profound ways. As we look forward, we're still in the early days of this generative AI revolution. If you just think about the difference from the original ChatGPT to the most recent versions, we're on an exponential curve. And these technologies and the insights that we're starting to glean and the data that underpins those insights that's starting to accelerate, you know, with very conscious experimentation, we're going to see a huge, huge progress over the course of the next year. At the same time, there are pieces of this equation that we have to adhere to kind of the current regulatory standards. So what's on our agenda for over the course of the next year, we have to execute really well on these first two clinical programs. And we're off to a great start. You know, the COVID program is entering its fifth cohort of patients. Anti-TSLP dosed the first patient in December. And we look forward to, you know, really executing well on those two studies. We believe that over the course of this year, we'll have another 2 to 3 INDs. So, you know, that is something that we're really, really focused on. We shared some data earlier this week on IL-13. That molecule looks special as well. And so we think, you know, for patients with atopic dermatitis, we have a really meaningful advance on that front. As we look forward, we're working on programs in immunology like TL1 alpha. We're working on infectious disease programs like flu. And our partnerships with Roswell Park and with MD Anderson are really focused on pushing the technology into cancer treatments. And so whether it be a T-cell engager, whether it be, you know, a bispecific, whether it be antibody-drug conjugates, you know, we're going to use the technology in the full array of modality applications to address major areas of unmet medical need. And then, you know, from a technology perspective, there are two things that, you know, we're really excited by. You mentioned CHROMA. CHROMA has been a landmark paper in terms of applying diffusion models to proteins. And the insights from CHROMA create new tools in our arsenal to attack disease. And we're starting to apply CHROMA in the de novo setting on an increasing basis. And what de novo protein generation allows you to do, it gives you a control and a specificity that traditional engineering does not allow. So if you think about how we have historically found antibodies, we immunize a human, a mouse, a llama, and we try and manipulate what the immune system gives us. Now we're basically programming with specificity the coordinates that we want to intersect with. And that's going to allow us to really, truly test the pure biological hypothesis versus borrowing what nature has given us. And then, you know, I think the other thing that we're spending a lot of time thinking about is how do we understand how structure intersects with function? And we invested heavily in a cryo-EM lab up in Andover to really push structural data generation to a new extreme. We believe over the course of this next year, we'll have more data than the public domain in terms of protein-protein interactions. And that'll allow us to truly design the next level of medicines where we actually are looking atomistically what's driving function and then design around those residues. And so over the course of the next year, there's a lot going on within the company. At the same time, the platform is extraordinarily scalable. And this is one of the things that excites me. You know, we intend to start 10 to 15 programs. Some of those will be generate
over time.
Next year. And some of those will be generate programs, but we'll also probably have another significant partnership like the Amgen partnership over the course of the next year. We're looking to do one more partnership. And we've been fortunate that I think, you know, the broader community is seeing the potential impact that these technologies can have on areas of unmet medical need.
And something you just said, I think for even those of us not with multiple decades in the industry can understand it, new tools to attack disease with control and specificity. And when it comes to the millions of people who suffer from asthma, you may have the Mona Lisa of molecules.
That's
pretty exciting.
It's really
Thank you so much for joining us in the studio.
Thanks, Christine.